So part two of the weekly stock market update, the public version, the private one for members of my Great Investments program is on the private Telegram channel, of course. So the S&P 500, where are we at the moment? Seems to be taking a bit of a breather, maybe going sideways. Remember, it's done that in the past on an upward rip. And in that period, it can always go down. Each one of those bars is weak. So it could have one, two, three, four, five down weeks before going back up. The critical factor is, what's the direction of travel there? That is still upwards, so I remain bullish. What I also wanted to show you on this, I've shown each year's gains roughly as a general rule of thumb, but not guaranteed. The markets will be up 5 years out of seven. Okay. And somebody asked me, well, what are you going to do in a bear market when it falls like in 2022? Well, what we did before, we ended up holding cash. What? You're going to be holding cash? Why aren't you finding companies which are going up when those markets are going down, whether in other countries or in that one? Be my guest. But on a year like that, I'm more than happy just to be holding cash. Well, why don't you hold something else like gold or Bitcoin or whatever? It's fine. Relax. You can diversify in different asset classes if you wish, but I'm not a specialist in gold or real estate or cryptocurrencies. So, like Warren Buffett, I focus on what I know, which is this bit. If you want to go and buy other asset classes like copper, for instance, be my guest. And if you can find companies when that's dropping, which are going up, which you feel confident in holding, you know, South Sea oil and alien exploration companies, feel free. But I'll be fine with my cash knowing that we're okay. But Alpesh, what if the market falls for the rest of your lifetime? Well, then we're all a bit screwed, aren't we? What if they turn off the stock market, Alpesh? What if the sky falls on our head? Indeed. Now, where are we on the FTSE 100? Well, it is 7% above 1999 levels. Congratulations. Well done, management. NASDAQ 100, still got more room to the upside before it becomes very overbought. Just because it is overvalued doesn't mean it can't continue upwards, because there are things such as growth and momentum which can drive things. Specifically, what does that mean? Well, would I buy the NASDAQ index, okay, at the moment? I do happen to have I checked in one of my ISAs with free trade. I do happen to have a NASDAQ tracker at the moment. Would I buy it? Am I continuing to hold it? Yes. Would I buy it afresh at the moment? Yeah, because I think we've still got a bit to go, though I probably won't do it today, because looking over my shoulder, the markets, the futures are down, so the markets will open lower. It doesn't mean they'll close lower, of course. So might not do it today, especially with the weekend coming. But I wouldn't have a problem. And would I have 2x leverage on that? You can get 3. I wouldn't do 3, because I don't like 3x leverage generally as a personal choice. Would I do 2 on that? I have in the past. At the moment, today, no. Apple. Now, as you know, lots of money was made. And I exited 50% of it because the MACD was falling below its own signal line. So I exited 50% of it, which meant it had dropped 15% from the peak by just so happens. Might drop lower. I think what will probably happen is one of those I'll probably buy back at some point in the future. I'll let you know when. So would I buy it today? No, because the MACD is falling below its own moving average. Would I continue holding it? Well, the other 50% I am for the moment. Would I sell that? Not yet. And I'd been whinging about this for a while, because I said, look, a fall's likely because we've got what's, you know, the price is making higher highs, the momentum lower highs. And we'll see if that holds. This position might hold, actually. It might just turn around and go up. I don't know, which is why I've got half the position still. But that's where we are with Apple. What about Alphabet's Great Investments Program, people only? Microsoft. Now, Microsoft, again, as I've said, it's getting closer to being overbought. Okay, it might be doing this again, which is fine, could fall for a bit and then go up. So there's probably still a bit more money to be made. As you know, it had a good week again. So what's our normal holding rule? As you know, on the Great Investments Program, the normal holding rule is 12 months, or if it drops 25% from the high since we bought it. Okay, well, none of those are there, but we could get out sooner if, as in the case of 2022, famously, not just with Meta, but a whole bunch of stocks, they all were doing the same thing, which is they were all showing that decline in momentum. We don't trade our investments, but it meant that year ended up being in cash just as well in hindsight, because Meta dropped 80%, which I didn't know it was going to drop that much, but it dropped 80% in that year. So we're not there with any of these, of course, otherwise I would tell you. But there's still some upside there. And I continue holding the 2x leverage Microsoft and the underlying Microsoft as well. Now, leverage is only for sophisticated people. So I don't mean sophisticated as in they speak posh and wear nice clothes. I mean sophisticated as in investors. So don't just go into leverage blindly, but it's because I was asked before this call. So it is a little bit overbought. Would I buy it today? Ugh. I wouldn't want to, but yeah, I could. I continue, of course, holding what I've got because we're sitting on big fat gains. And that's the point I made with Meta. See what happened there? They were all doing this in January of 2022. When cross securities, you get the same overbought thing happening, then you know there's a problem and it may well be time to look to get out. And that's what had indeed happened in that instance. It was time really to start getting out in 2022. Amazon's great investments program. Disney, I continue holding, as you know. Would I buy more today if I had to? But it's doing well. Thank you very much, Mr. Disney. Why? Well, because again, it was on the value, growth, income, cash flow, Sortino. Let me show you that. There we go. It was on all those lists for us, and that's why it met our criteria. Once it meets the criteria, if you've watched my broadcast, then you will know. For instance, this is the FTSE 100. And people say, well, why do you only have American ones? Well, there's only a bloody 100 companies in here, whereas if I go into the full-blown thing here, you've got 10,000 to pick from. I'm not obsessed with a particular country. In other words, I've often said, I'm not a racist when it comes to picking stocks. I'm not a racist in other areas, I don't think, but I don't like green people. So this is why I look at largely American, because there's just more companies to choose from. I don't care what nationality they are. Wish they had as many companies in Britain. Now, Disney met those criteria of value, growth, income, cash flow, Sortino, Alpha. And by the way, Alpha is important. Alpha is what you always want. So we just pick Alpha stocks. What's Alpha? It means when the market goes up, they go up more. When the market falls, they also go up more. It's all you want, isn't it? Can't guarantee it'll happen every time. That's on YouTube. Watch that video. It's amazing. Nvidia, now again, did I know it was going to go up this much? No. So why did we get in January of last year? Well, because momentum wasn't falling and value, growth, income, it was on the approved list, value, growth, income, cash flow, Sortino, Alpha, and so on. Did I know it was going to go up this much? I'll say it again. No, I did not. Forget that thing. I keep deleting it. My team keep adding that on. That projection on, they're just getting a bit overexcited. It is overbought. It will fall. So why haven't I sold it? Well, why should I sell it in advance? When it drops 10%, I'll make a decision whether I sell 10%, 20%, 30%, 40%, 50%, 60%, or 100%. Okay, I'll make that decision then. That's objective. It's mathematical. Far easier than trying to read the news and decide whether or not I should sell Nvidia. As happened here, you could have had two rules. Either you have my usual MACD momentum rule, or if you can't manage that, if it drops X percent from the high since you bought it, get the hell out. That's it. Okay. Tesla, as you know, we had it as a special situation. That means it didn't meet all our requirements, value, growth, income, cash flow, Sortino, but it met a lot of them. And what had happened is we got out in October. Now it's fallen off and still not one I'd look to get into as a special situation or otherwise. Why do I mention it? Well, because it's popular and this broadcast is for... it is actually to also give you an idea of the markets. Now, I'm going to keep this below 10 minutes. In part three, I'm going to talk about, well, not Meta, because that's great investments program only. I'm going to talk about NXP and what I am doing. And it's going to be surprisingly shocking. Tune into part three.